The commissioner, who is also a member of parliament for Nyendo Mukungwe, Mathias Mpoga, today addressed journalists at the premises of parliament, where he revealed the outcomes of consultations he has been carrying out among various stakeholders. Mpoga says among the key issues he has been consulting about is the necessity of instituting electoral reforms before the 2026 general election. He says this is the only guarantee Ugandans can have a free and fair election.
Talked about the facts that we needed as the opposition, a workable framework that will make the opposition functional beyond rhetoric and posturing. That the opposition at this stage should be in a position to posit the country into the possibilities. The opposition must engender a framework in which it has a common voice, and that voice must transcend color.
In his address, Mpoga rallied members of the opposition to retract from their comfort zones and act to have electoral reforms. In his highlights, one of the critical areas that he says requires reforms is the size of parliament. Mpoga says it is important that the parliament is restructured to a number of MPs that reflect Uganda's economy.
Over the last couple of years, even when I was still LOP, I talked about these reforms, including reforms that will go a long way in reducing the size of parliament to rhyme with the capacity of the nation to support a sizable, purposeful and useful parliament.
Among other reforms he cited is the return of term limits, as well as reforms in the appointment of the Electoral Commission, among others. Mpoga also faulted the current leader of opposition for not continually pressing the government to release political prisoners. He said he has written to the Speaker of Parliament to reawaken this conversation. The trial of Molly Katanga, a widow who is also accused of murdering her husband, Henry Katanga, has continued for the second day, with the prosecution presenting its third and fourth witnesses in the matter. On the witness stand today was Peter Ogwang, the officer in charge of Bugolobi Police Station. Ogwang testified in the High Court that one of the accused, Patricia Kakwanzi, the daughter of the late businessman Henry Katanga, asked him to cover up her father's death by reporting it as an accident. However, during cross-examination, it was established that some accounts of his oral testimony were not included in his written statement, which he recorded on November 6th, days after the incident.
A structure of the body laid down on a mattress. I saw a structure of the body. Laid down and a pistol nearby.
The defense, consisting of Edson Karuhanga, Mark Damson Kabega, Bruce Musinguzi, John Jett Tumwebaze and Peter Kabatsi, then asked the court to accept his statement as their exhibit, raising questions about the reliability of the witness's testimony. In a separate testimony, Timothy Nyagwesho, the deceased nephew, described his attempt to reach his uncle on the day of the incident. Nyagwesho said he tried calling Katanga on both his lines, but they both went unanswered.
Then I told her I had an appointment with Uncle Henry at 1 p.m. and I inquired about his whereabouts. Mother responded and told me he was sleeping, that I should call back later. At about 9:30, my mom called me back. Uncle Henry was dead.
His mother, an elder sister to Katanga, advised him to call Martha, who instead advised him to call back later because the father was sleeping. But when he called his mother again, she informed him that Katanga was dead.
My lord, the number on this statement is not the one in my phone.
I'm not just technical reports and keep putting it to the witness without demonstrating how this witness is connected.
The prosecution, which was being represented by Assistant DPP Samalu Wakoli, Chief State Attorneys Jonathan Mwaganya and Anna Chiza, requested an adjournment to bring more witnesses, which was granted by the court. All accused individuals except Molly Katanga, who appeared through a Zoom link connecting to Lusira Women Prison, are currently out on bail. The matter will resume on Friday this week. A massive fire erupted at Islamabad's today, engulfing over 700 stalls. Firefighters battled for several hours to bring the blaze under control. The incident occurred at the capital's open-air market, where vendors set up stalls each week to sell a wide variety of goods. The Islamabad administration reported that the fire originated in the market section dedicated to shoe and garments. The blaze quickly escalated, spreading to adjacent sections, including the area where kitchen utensils were sold, engulfing a vast area of merchandise in the flames. Firefighting teams faced a challenging task in controlling the inferno. 31 fire brigades were mobilized to tackle the blaze. The intense operation required coordinated efforts to prevent further spread and damage. No casualties have so far been reported. However, goods worth millions of rupees stored in the stores were reduced to ashes, prompting vendors to voice their grievances to the market administration. Meanwhile, the Islamabad police said that the entire area surrounding the market has been cordoned off and evidence is being collected from the scene to ascertain the cause of the fire.